Benjamin Netanyahu has vowed to retaliate after an assassination attempt by Iran via their proxy Hezbollah on the weekend. His home was targeted and he warned this was a grave mistake.
Prime Minister, how is it going?
Well, 2 days ago, we took out Yahya Sinwar, the terrorist mastermind whose goons beheaded our men, raped our women, burnt babies alive. We took him out, and we're continuing our battle with Iran's other terrorist proxies. We're going to win this war.
So will something deter you?
No.
Defiant there. And thankfully, Netanyahu and his wife, Sara, weren't at home in Caesarea when Hezbollah launched 3 drones on Saturday. But you have to ask, why is Qatar harbouring the likely new leader of Hamas, Khalil al-Haya? Where is the international pressure on Qatar to force the release of the hostages and to stop protecting these Hamas leaders? Why does the international community, why are we not hearing from the likes of Penny Wong proper pressure on Qatar, only Israel? Well, let's cross live now to Renana, where I'm joined by Israel's special envoy for combating anti-Semitism, Michal Cotler-Wunsh. Michal, thank you very much for your time. Look, we have to hope that Netanyahu is stepping up what you'd presume is already tough security amid this alarming assassination attempt.
Yeah, you're 100% right. It is alarming. And it is yet one more symptom of what you referred to, which is actually the emboldening of genocidal terror proxies, Hamas, Hezbollah, the Houthis, of a murderous Islamic regime in Iran, all of them hell-bent and openly intent to annihilate the state of Israel and murder Jews, just like Mein Kampf. And the unbelievable fact that we have been in this sort of multi-front war on the state of Israel, launched on October 7th, but not at all ended on October 7th. And I don't know if you viewers know, but just in the last 48 hours, barrages, hundreds of rockets have targeted Israel's north, Haifa, and the cities along the coast from up north, Hezbollah, one of the genocidal terror proxies, meaning the emboldening of these terror proxies and their supporting murderous regime in Iran is what should trouble all democracies, because in fact what they indicate is that those entities are emboldened to attack in this war of barbarism on civilization all of our democracies.
Yeah.